Considering a mortgage for a home purchase can be intimidating, and it should be. Taking out a mortgage is one of the biggest financial decisions you can make. And unfortunately, many banks will try to entice you to borrow as much as you can for as long as you can. Don't fall for that bait. You need to make sure your mortgage works for you. That's why I'm going to walk you through the different aspects of choosing a mortgage to help you choose the best options for your financial situation and your goals. Hey, it's Shiraz Ali, realtor with Royal LePage Dynamic in Winnipeg, Manitoba. I offer clients a diverse range of expertise from representing clients on both the buy and sale side, investments, land purchases, development, and financing. If you'd like to learn more about buying, selling, or investing in real estate, please subscribe to my YouTube channel using the button below. Also, if you want to stay updated with the latest content, make sure to hit that bell button. Which mortgage is best for you depends on your financial goals, but I would recommend the best mortgage is one that you can afford while paying as little to your lender as possible over the duration of the mortgage term. Banks trying to make it as easy as possible to rope you in for the long haul by allowing you to take out a large mortgage over a longer period than you can realistically afford. This is why it's your responsibility as the borrower to know what you're getting into. But luckily, you have good old Shiraz here to guide you. Your amortization will depend on how much of a down payment you can pay up front toward the purchase of that home. If you put down a 20% down payment or more of the purchase price, this is called a conventional mortgage. A conventional mortgage can be amortized over as long as 30 years. If your down payment is between 5 and 20% of your purchase price, you will have to get a high ratio mortgage. A high ratio mortgage can only be amortized over a maximum of 25 years. And it also requires you to purchase mortgage default insurance. Remember, the banks will try to lend you as much money as possible for as long as they can. This is how they make their money, from the interest. When you and your mortgage specialist agree on the amortization period, you next decide on the length of your upcoming term and the details of that term, such as interest rate type, payment amount, and payment frequency. With a fixed rate mortgage, your rate and monthly payment will stay the same for the term of that mortgage. A variable rate mortgage will often be lower than a fixed rate for the same term, but the rate will change with the prime lending rate as set by your lender. This means if the Bank of Canada's prime mortgage rate goes up, so will yours. This is why paying attention to interest rate and terms is so important. Paying 5% interest of $250,000 over a 5-year term is $15,000 worth of interest, while paying 4% interest over a 6-year term is $10,000. By the way, I should also mention that if you're interested in learning more about the first home purchase process, check out my 4 essential steps to buying your first home. Click the link above or at the end of this video. The last two factors I want to touch on are payment amount and frequency. The significance of your payment amount is pretty straightforward. The more you pay, the sooner your mortgage will be paid off, and the sooner you will own that property free and clear. Payment frequency also makes a huge difference. The more often you make payments, the less overall interest you will pay. Before you take out a mortgage, make sure you budget accurately on how much you can afford to pay and how often. This way, you can choose a rate and term that works for you rather than the other way around. We've now covered the key factors in determining which mortgage is best for you. I've said it before and I'll say it again. The best mortgage is one that you can realistically afford. This is why it's so important to come to your mortgage meeting knowing how much you can afford and not agreeing to spend more than that. If you learned something today, please like this video, share it with someone else, subscribe to my channel, or all three. And if you have any questions about mortgages you'd like me to answer in future videos, please ask them in the comments section below. I'd also love to help you discover your real estate investment potential as your go-to consultant.